Hi, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It is such a delight and a pleasure to have you watch this video. I'm excited to have you here. My name is Wayne Akwan. On today's video, I want to talk about something that is an encouragement to me and then to you. That's why I'm sharing it anyways. It's simple. You can trust God. You can trust God. I had this series of thoughts came to me a while ago, which I brought all of these that I want to speak to you on. The thoughts were, God can do whatever, however, whenever. So to me, kind of like play on words, was like the WHW of trusting God. It was exciting to me when I thought about that at first. And it's true that God can do whatever, however, whenever. So I'm gonna break that down to actually get to a tangible point that leads to this encouragement. You can trust God. Is it easy to trust God? My answer would be, I don't think it is easy to trust God, but I think it is worth it to trust God. It may not be easy, but it's actually simple. And simple and easy doesn't mean the same thing. It's simple, which means it's not a complex thing. Like, it's not something that is as complex as the religious way. It is just not easy. Because our human nature, naturally, we tend to drift to things that we can see, touch, and feel with our senses. And then you hear people talk about things like seeing is believing, which is totally not what the Bible says. And then people go about with all of those things. So now you start trusting God and they'll be in this haste. God, how are you going to do this? And when are you going to do this? When, God, when am I going to get married? When am I going to get the miracle? Okay, I'm having a headache now, but I just prayed. When is the healing coming? Oh God, the headache is not gone. The symptom is still there. It's like the prayer has not been answered. Get into this haste situation, which we would not be in if we can trust God the right way. So God can do whatever. Whatever actually depicts the thing. Is it the miracle? Is it the healing of the headache, the heartache, the cancer, the diabetes? Is it the provision? Whatever it is. God doing whatever speaks about the thing and His ability and God's ability. Can God do this? What does the Bible have to say about this? In Luke chapter 1, verse 37, God's word says, "For with God, nothing will be impossible." Which means, well, in all of eternity, what it has to do with God, nothing, no thing at all will be. Nothing has been in the past, and nothing is right now, and nothing will be. Why is it like that? God is the first and the last, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega. So nothing in the all of eternity and time will be impossible for God. So with this, God can do whatever. And you need to know God's character, because God is good. When I say whatever, it doesn't mean that God can sin. Is sin good? Is it in God's character? No. God can do whatever. He is all powerful. He is sovereign. We talk about the story of Abraham in Genesis chapter 18, verse 14. Abraham was an old man. God had made a promise to him that he would have a son. Sarah was very old and past childbearing age. And the angel is here talking to Abraham. Sarah, your wife, is going to give birth. Sarah is there laughing. Angel, my Lord is called, that's how Sarah called Abraham. My Lord is old and I'm past childbearing age. I don't think you really know what he's saying. The angel said to Abraham, Sarah is laughing. Is anything too hard for the Lord? The Lord, the word uses Yahweh, a self-existent one. If he created himself, is anything then really hard for him to do? He exists alone. There has not been an election to his throne or his power. He's sovereign above all. Is anything too hard for the Lord? An angel said, at the appointed time I will return unto you, and Sarah shall have a child. And it happened as he said. This talks about God's capability. With God, all things are possible. God is capable of everything, and nothing is outside of God's capability. Nothing is outside of God's power to do. No sickness is outside of God's power to heal. No provision is outside of God's power to make for his people. Luke 18:27 says, but he said, the things which are impossible with men are possible with God. Impossibility only exists in the realm of men. We as humans, because of what? We are powerless and limited. But with God, all things are possible. So God can do whatever he wants to do. He made highways through the sea in Egypt, the Red Sea. He has made rivers in the wilderness. Waters out of the rock. The virgin birth. Ooh, amazing. Never happened before. Never happened after that. The virgin birth. With no contact with a man. Nothing that comes from a man to fertilize the womb. The virgin birth. So God is capable of everything. God can do anything. And you can trust God because he can do anything. God can do anything however he wants to do it. And when it comes to the context of the life we live. We are impatient because we ask God, do this for me. And then we go ahead and start thinking, maybe God, you should use this person. Maybe you should do it this way. It's just like someone getting into a relationship. And because you so much think you love someone or really feel love for someone, you're like, God, make this my wife. God, use, let it be this person. Let it be this person. At some point, it could be that it happens, you marry the person and that's who God wants you to be with. I'm not trying to say there's a specific one person that God wants you to be with. But God really knows you and He knows who can fit with you. I think it would be better you asking God before you get there, before you bring something to Him to make into what you want. We find ourselves in this place that we ask God, how are you going to do it? As if we want to help Him to do it. God, is there a way you need assistance for me to help you? How do you want to do this? How do you want this done? So maybe I can assist you one way or the other. God doesn't need your assistance to do what it needs to do. When we get to a place of facing impossibilities, we start feeling like, how will God do this? How is this even possible? Of course, it's impossible. But it's impossible only to you, not to God. Your how still finds its answer in the who promised to do it. Just like when Jesus died and the people went there to the tomb, the ladies were going there and they were like, who is going to help us roll away the stone? How will we be able to roll away the stone? God has sent His angel, the stone was rolled, Christ had already risen. And I'm just trying to give this as a perspective to, if you need something and then it seems impossible for you, instead of going about how can this be done, you look for who has the ability to do it. So in this context, everything we need in life, it's only God that can do anything. But then the how depends on Him, however He wants to do it, not on us. That's God's own responsibility, not mine, not yours. God, how do you want to heal me? Or how do you want to remove the cancer? But that's not your business. It's God's business. Your business is to trust. How will God do this? Mary asked, how can this be? In Luke chapter 1 verse 34, when the angel told Mary, you're going to give birth to a son. You know, Mary as a human knows that giving birth to any child, to an offspring, is as a result of a man and a woman having intercourse. That's how a child comes to be. And how can this be, since I do not know a man? The angel said, the how is not your problem. The Holy Ghost will come upon you and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Like, it's God telling us, the how is not your problem. All you need to do is just believe. And then this is where I said to her, with God, all things are possible. At this point, Mary said, amen to God's promise. Be it unto me according to your word. And I think when we receive a promise from God, we don't go about trying to act like we want to help God do what He wants to do in our lives. I'm trying to find out, trying to figure out how He wants to do it. But it's a trust that is kind of like, I don't know anything, but I trust you. I don't want to understand anything because I can't even understand even if I try. So I will trust you. That's the kind of trust God wants from us. God can do anything, anyhow. And let's leave the how to Him. Let Him do it His own way. So we don't get to dictate how God works the miracle, how God brings the healing, how God brings the provision. That's not on us. We let Him do it. He's the God. We don't try to play God. The other issue with trusting God on our part as humans is the question, when? God, when? God, when? God, when? But when do you want to give me this? God, when do you want to give me that? I want to remind you today, you can trust God. The when is not an issue. The when is not an issue to God. It's only an issue to you because you feel like time has passed. Your time has gone by. You feel like you're growing old. So time is running by. But let me tell you, it's because you're waiting on this when. That's why you cannot trust God, because you are there questioning God instead of trusting Him. God, when? God, when? God, when? Instead of like, God, I'm waiting on you. They that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. The result of waiting on the Lord is that your strength will be renewed. He didn't say they that wait on the miracle. He didn't say they that wait on the provision. He didn't say they that wait on the marriage. He didn't say they that wait on the child. He said they that wait on the Lord. Which is, I'm waiting on the Lord because I know He alone is able to do this. Paul Apostle said something which I love so much. For I know whom I have believed. I am persuaded He is able to keep that which I have committed unto Him until that day. So it's not about the how. It's not about the when. It's more about the who do you know? Who are you believing? Who are you believing? Who is your faith in? Is He able? That's what you should think about. For I know whom I have believed. He is able. When we going to God when, God when. It seems as if we can have anything to do with time. But the truth is that we cannot do anything with time. We can't move it forward. We can't take it slower. Even when we worry, we can't change anything. God, when are you going to bring the miracle? God, when is the baby coming? And God is like, pause before you ask when. Time is not a problem to me. I can do anything whenever. You can trust God. He can do it now. He can do it tomorrow. He can make the breakthrough come. Time is not a construct that God is constrained to. God is not constrained to time. I've never seen a thing made having control over who made it. God created time. Time is a created thing. And since time is a created thing, the creator himself controls time. Yeah, God can push time. God can restore time. I will restore to you the years, the Kakawam and the Lucas have eaten. Do you have faith in God? You can trust God. I just want to encourage you as much as I encourage myself. God can restore time. Time is not an issue to God. It's not a problem to God. He's outside of time. He's in eternity. He made time. He's the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. God alone defines time. Time is in the control of God. So when you go to asking God when, you should know that is not your responsibility. Your responsibility is to wait on the Lord, trust Him, believe He is able. Jesus did many miracles in the Bible. He healed many blind people. He never healed all of them the same way. Some of them received it immediately. Time. Some, the how was in making mud and putting on their eyes and told them, go and watch. It was a process for some, which means it wasn't immediate, but it was a process, but it was still done. So when you want to know the how, and the way, that is not your problem. That is God's. Leave that to God. That's God's battle. My duty and your duty is trust Him. You can trust God. My responsibility and yours is to believe that He can. God can. And that He will. God will. In the promises of God, He keeps saying, I will. I will. That's the word that marks a promise. I will do this. I will do that. He has a lot of promises that He has given to us. God can do anything, anyhow, anytime. Time is not a problem to Him. Let's check this story in Matthew chapter 8, verse 2 and 3. Let me wrap up with this. So there's this leper. After Jesus had preached the sermon on the mount, and he came down the mount, there's this leper that meets up with Jesus. And it is believed that this leper must have heard all of Jesus' words. It was against the law for a leper to be out there. Lepers were ostracized. They were not to commune with anybody because of their condition. And there are a lot of people in real life that their condition has caused them not to be able to relate with people, because their condition have created this shame or makes them really go into solitude. This leper, against all odds, came to meet with Jesus because he has heard about Jesus, I believe. And maybe he has heard Jesus and his word is full of power, his word is full of authority. And then look at what this leper said to Jesus. And behold, a leper came and worshipped him, saying, Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean. Ooh. It's not doubt God's ability, God's capability, God's omnipotence to make him clean. The only thing that was an issue to him was God's willingness, Jesus' willingness. Lord, if you are willing, and this is a pure example of where we should be in our journey of faith. You trust in God's ability, believing that God can, believing that He is able. Because the Bible says God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we can ever ask or think. So it's not about your prayer that can make the miracle come. You don't have faith in faith, you have faith in God. It's your faith in God that brings the miracle, not your faith that you have believed God. It's your faith that God is able that brings the miracle. So this man said, Lord, I know you can, but I doubt you will. So if you are willing, you can make me clean. How did Jesus respond to this man? Jesus touched him. The next verse, then Jesus put out his hand and touched him, saying, I am willing. And I want you to hear it as if God is speaking to you today. You asking God, are you willing to do this? He says, I am willing. You can trust that. I am willing. So my duty and your duty today and every day of our lives is to believe that God is able to do what He said He will do, and He is willing to do it for us. If you doubt His willingness, the Bible says, if God did not spare His only begotten Son, but gave Him up for us all, how then will He not with Him give us everything or anything else? If God could give us Jesus, what else is greater? What else would God not give? The healing, the provision, the breakthrough? What else would God not give? Or what else would he withhold? God is not withholding anything. God wants to release it. Are you trusting in him? Am I waiting on him? Am I trusting in his ability to do what he said he will do? Am I trusting in his willingness to do what he said he will do? Or am I asking God when? Am I waiting or am I questioning? So I get to change my perception and start trusting that God can do all he said he would do. And then he wants to do it because he promised it. And God cannot fail. His words cannot fail. If he said it, he will do it. So it's not my place to search out the promises of God in the Bible. I wish that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. God wants me well. God wants me to do well. And it is God that gives you the power to get wealth. God wants me to be wealthy for his glory. God wants me to be healthy and not just hope to receive healing. He wants me to be in health, which makes me think that being in health is better than looking for healing. So at this point, Jesus said to this man, I'm willing, be cleansed. Now check the progress. Jesus decided to give him a touch. He has not received a human touch for so long. Jesus touched him. So you are accepted. I'm willing. And we all as children of God are accepted in the beloved in Christ. We are accepted in him as scriptures say we all accepted in Jesus, and God is willing to give us everything we need. And for me, I feel like God wants us prepared because he doesn't want to give us a blessing that becomes a burden. He doesn't want to give us the blessings that come with sorrows. Because if God blesses you with something that you cannot handle, then that's not a blessing per se. Jesus touched him and said, be cleansed. The Bible says immediately his leprosy was cleansed. This talks about the time. Our duty is not to wait on how is God going to do it, when is God going to do it. Our duty is, God, I believe you can, and I'm trusting that you will. God, I believe you can, and I'm trusting that you will. You can trust God. Proverbs 3 verse 5 and 6 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. Lean not on your own smarts. Lean not on your own strategy. Lean not on thinking that by praying for so-so and so-so hours, God will make God bring a miracle. Lean not on thinking in your own mind that maybe praising God will make God's kind of God be excited. No, God can't be flattered with your praise. Neither mine. God is not flattered with praise. God can't be flattered. You can't praise God to make him do something. He's not human. He is not human. You can praise me as I am. Maybe I did a little thing, or may not even have done anything, but you start praising my personality, and then it makes me kind of like, oh, I'm so excited. God is not saying, God knows your heart. He knows everything about you. So why are you going to flatter? Because he knows the only reason you're praising him is to get what you want. And God is not interested in that. It's not transactional. Like I'm using this praise as the currency to get what I want. No, God doesn't want that. He doesn't operate that way. I believe that's my personal opinion. I believe he already loves us. He already wants to give. He is willing. He has already made the promise. And all we need is, God, I'm trusting you. God, I have my confidence in you. God, I'm waiting on you. Let this strength be renewed. Build me up. I don't just wait, sit down, cross my legs. I'm trusting God. The result of me waiting will be renewed strength, which is healing on the inside and on the outside. God healing me from my insecurities. God healing me from my ego. God taking down my pride to help me take his gift and value his gift the right way. Because even the Bible says, do not give precious things to pigs. So if I keep behaving like a pig, how will God bring something precious to me? Because I won't know the value if he brings it. So I have to grow myself to a place of, I am ready to take this. Well, side note, nobody will ever be perfectly ready for anything. All we can do is trust in God to work on us, to prepare us for the blessing he has ahead of us. I hope this has been a blessing to you. And if it has been a blessing, to be my utmost joy and pleasure to have you subscribe to my channel. It will help the channel grow. Then you can share this video to others whom you think will be a blessing to. Share the video, like, give a comment under the comment section. I would really love to hear from you and keep bringing content like this your way. Stay blessed and have a blessed time. See you in the next video. God bless.